never believe it.
BTS, we love you.
We should find the way to love ourselves of our own.
They're not just a band, they are a support.
Thank you and love you. You're my everything.
We got a little bit older, a little bit happier, but we're still us.
Famous K-pop group BTS has been churning out hit after hit since they were teens. But now, the BTS Army is forced to deal with the reality that their new favorite band is going to be taking an extended break. BTS made their debut all the way back in 2012, and they haven't stopped delivering awesome music or accumulating devoted fans ever since. So you can imagine our surprise when they announced that the Lotte duty-free family concert would be their last, at least for a while. That's right, the Bangtan boys are taking a sabbatical from the music industry, and it's official. Big Hit Entertainment announced the group would be taking a break via a statement confirming the two-month hiatus. For the very first time since their debut, BTS will be embarking on an official period of rest and relaxation. The group members have been working as brand models for Lotte duty-free shops since 2017 and are no strangers to their annual music festival, but this year's performance marked the beginning of their break. According to the statement issued by Big Hit Entertainment, this period of rest will allow the members to recharge and prepare to present themselves anew as musicians and creators. It also points out that they're all young people in their 20s, and this will give them a chance to enjoy the lives of ordinary people at least a little bit. Fans camped outside the venue for days before the performance, so clearly BTS doesn't have to worry about their popularity waning, so what's the real reason for this rest period? The statement specifically mentioned the group members recharging in their own personal ways, which could point to an emphasis on solo work. Tae-hyung Kim, better known as V, released his song Winter Bear in August 2019, which is the first he's put out in English. Even though this was a solo song, he did have some help from fellow BTS members RM, who assisted with the translation. Winter Bear follows his first solo track, Scenery, which came out in January 2019. Not only did V do it all himself, but he even provided the photograph for the cover artwork. The song broke SoundCloud records by reaching 100 million streams in over 14 days, the shortest time yet. It also went on to break the daily streaming record 9 times. Yet during an interview with Ryan Seacrest in May 2019, the band seemed ambivalent about the topic of solo careers. Jin said no, while RM gave a slightly more open to interpretation, not yet. In the world of K-pop, it's not uncommon for group members to pursue solo careers, yet these guys do tend to stick together, even on solo projects. When Seokjin Kim released Tonight in June of 2019, he also had some help from RM when it came to writing the lyrics. Although the group is notoriously close with one another, they admitted during the Ryan Seacrest interview that they do work on maintaining some boundaries with one another. This break could be a way for them to stretch their wings and grow as both individuals and artists. In the past, Jungkook has expressed an interest in doing a mixtape, but feels none of the material he's created so far has been good enough. RM says, if the quality isn't there, the song just isn't released. It's clear the group holds itself to sky-high standards, which have contributed to its success over the years. But while they know how to work together as a group, maybe it's time they all work on finding themselves and their own musical voices. Together, they have no problem getting rave reviews, like when they released their record-breaking music video for Boy With Love. Once it was put on YouTube, it racked up 74.6 million views in just the first 24 hours. This absolutely decimated the previous 56.7 million record previously held by fellow K-pop group Blackpink. The video features performer Halsey, who commended BTS on both their hard work and talent. The very same day the video was released, BTS also became the first Asian group to perform on Saturday Night Live. But just because they're insanely popular and insanely talented doesn't mean they don't have to follow the rules. In South Korea, all able-bodied men must serve a minimum of 21 months in the military. They have the world's 7th highest number of active troops and the highest number of reserve troops, and they're always recruiting more. The possibility of being conscripted is a serious one, and it's caused a lot of controversies. Musicians and athletes are frequently exempt from being conscripted, and many wonder just how fair that really is. It's a reality the group has thought about, even if they'd rather not. When asked about the possibility, Chin said that when duty calls, the group will be ready to respond and do their best. Jungkook seemed unsure how being conscripted would affect their group dynamic and noted that BTS has something really good going. RM claims they want to enjoy the ride and live in the moment instead of fretting over the idea of being conscripted.
That's all we could do.
It definitely seems like being conscripted would be a huge step backward for the band, and it's possible they might not be able to recover from it. There are many people who believe stars like the members of BTS should also be exempt from military service, but it remains to be seen if policy will change in time for this group. Could the looming possibility of military service have influenced the group's decision to take a sabbatical from working? Being a K-pop star is definitely an enviable career, but if they go straight from stardom to the military, they could easily breeze through their 20s without experiencing anything resembling normalcy. Going from being a member of the best-selling group in South Korea to being a member of the armed forces would be a ridiculously difficult adjustment under the best of circumstances. The Hyundai Research Institute in Seoul estimates that BTS alone brings in about $3.6 billion per year to the economy, and yes, that's billion with a B. They also estimate that one out of every 13 tourists visits South Korea for reasons relating to BTS. Since the system offers exemptions to those who raise the national profile, then it seems kind of crazy that groups like BTS aren't considered eligible for exemption while single-time Olympic medalists are. Just because you're a massive K-pop star doesn't mean you get special treatment in this regard. Just ask Yoo Sung-jun, who was once known as one of South Korea's biggest stars. That is, of course, until he was accused of trying to evade his time in the military. He had claimed that he would definitely fulfill his mandatory military service, yet just before he was set to be drafted, he became a naturalized United States citizen. Needless to say, this didn't go over too well in the court of public opinion or with the South Korean government. It was considered an act of desertion, which resulted in his deportation and banishment from the country. Although Yoo Sung-jun would later regret and apologize for his actions, begging to be allowed back in South Korea, his ban remains in place. So getting around the rules is not really an option. Unless some drastic policy reform happens, the members of BTS will be expected to report for duty just like any other men of suitable age in South Korea. It's possible this is one of the reasons BTS fans are being so supportive over the band's break. The BTS Army even started #RestWellBTS, designed to give encouragement to their favorite K-pop group during this time. Not only are the guys taking a break from music, but they're respectfully asking for a break from their fans as well. The statement from Big Hit Entertainment specifically asks fans to show consideration for their need to rest and enjoy their private time off if they happen to encounter a member of BTS in public. Even before the group debuted, the group members were incredibly popular on social media. They started posting about 6 months before their debut, which helped generate excitement and ensure their success. Their fans have helped them enter the Guinness Book of World Records multiple times. But let's not forget that all of these achievements and all of these fans didn't happen overnight. Big Hit Entertainment CEO Bang Si-hook was known for writing popular songs like One Candle and Like the First Time, but admits he often felt insecure about his contributions to the music industry. He admired stars who managed to express their personalities via their music and kept that in mind when putting together a group he called the Bulletproof Boy Scouts. Unlike the perfectly polished K-pop bands so many entertainment companies were pushing out, Bang was determined to showcase the authentic personalities of the members of this group. It started out with him being impressed by RM's rapping, and then he ended up recruiting the other members of the group. According to RM, the group stands out because they frequently write their own songs, manage their own social media, and focus on their joint projects instead of solo careers. The youngest member of BTS is Jungkook, who was about 15 years old when he joined BTS. The oldest member of the group was Suga, who was about 20 years old during the official BTS debut. They've spent so much of their life devoted to the group and to each other that it's no wonder they're ready for a brief break. Of course, creating music, learning choreography, and performing during sold-out shows are far from easy, but there are many other things which make being in a K-pop group challenging. A controversy that may be quickly forgotten elsewhere in the world can absolutely ruin a K-pop star career. Lee Sung-hyung, better known as Seungri, was once a popular member of the hit group Big Bang. But in 2019, he was accused of tax evasion, bribery, and far more unsavory things. This resulted in the termination of his contract with YG Entertainment and his retirement from the entertainment industry. Obviously, this sent a shockwave through the K-pop community, and BTS was asked about its impact. The group members used this as a platform to promise their fans that they'll stay away from trouble. According to Suga, this has been their plan since the group first started from a pure an innocent place. While we definitely think they should avoid following in the footsteps of Seungri, we can see how the high standards K-pop stars are held to could start to feel confining after all of this time. Taking a brief break could be a great way to relax without feeling the need to rebel against the industry. Already, the guys have gotten to relax instead of attending the 2019 Teen Choice Awards, even though they had been nominated for various awards. They ended up winning Choice International Artist, Choice Fandom, Choice Summer Tour, and Choice Collaboration for Boy with love. And the BTS Army show that they deserve the Choice Fandom Award by supporting the group sitting this event out and just sitting back and collecting the accolades. Already, the Army is speculating on when BTS will release a new album as a comeback after their sabbatical. Some hopeful fans believe it could be as early as October 2019. What do you think about BTS taking a break? Do you think it's well-deserved, or do you think it's just too painful for their fans?
Thank you to all our fans for making this dream come true, and we'll be back.
Let us know what you think in the comment section, and then click on the subscribe button for more videos from us here at The Taco. Bye for now.